Math 1, Unit 7, Building Quadratic Functions. Practice isn't the thing you do once you're good. It's the thing that you do that makes you good. As you start this unit, use this quote to help you reflect on how you study mathematics. The big ideas for this unit include operating with linear expressions, creating multiple representations of quadratic functions, and using those representations to find key features of the function. In this unit, you will add, subtract, and multiply linear expressions. You will write equations, create tables and graphs to represent quadratic patterns, and find key features of quadratic functions. Key mathematical tools that we will use in this unit include diagrams, algebra tiles, expressions, equations, tables, and graphs. In the first four lessons, you will perform operations with linear expressions. In Lesson 1, you will add expressions to find the perimeter of a figure. In Lesson 2, you will add and subtract expressions to solve problems in and out of context. In Lesson 3, you will multiply linear expressions to create area models and represent area with quadratic expressions. Lesson 4 is a practice understanding lesson. In this lesson, you will write linear expressions from word problems, multiply the expression to solve problems, and write equivalent forms of quadratic expressions. In the last four lessons, you will explore patterns and key features of quadratic functions. You will write expressions to represent quadratic relationships and discover patterns found in the first and second differences of quadratic functions. You will represent a quadratic function with a graph, table, diagram, and equations. You'll describe the rate of change in quadratic functions and use the structure of parabolas and equations to find the domain, range, intercepts, axis of symmetry, and vertex of a quadratic function. Here's a list of key vocabulary terms for this unit. Some of these vocabulary terms should already be familiar to you from previous courses. Here are some key skills needed to be successful with the content in this unit. You should be able to add, subtract, factor, and expand linear expressions. Understand that rewriting expressions into equivalent forms can reveal other relationships between quantities. Construct a function to model a linear relationship. Understand the definition of a function. And you should be able to determine the rate of change and initial value of linear functions from tables and graphs. In addition to your teacher and school-based resources, there are several additional resources available. The Ready, Set, Go homework help videos are housed in the Canvas site for your class. You can access these in Canvas using your student login. If you do not know how to log into Canvas, ask your teacher for help. The K-12 Math Resources website, which can be found on your school's website, includes additional support items such as unit and lesson overviews, videos overviewing the tasks, essential vocabulary, the North Carolina standards for each unit, learning targets for each lesson, and extra practice problems.